It's exciting. There's lots of joy. It's a good evening to be here. The weather is good. The roads are clear. Welcome, everyone. Come on, can I hear you make some noise as we welcome the worship team this evening? Come on, make some noise. Has God been good to you? God is good. And all the time. One more time, God has been good, worship harvest. And all the time. And that deserves a high five. Come on now. Let's put our hands together and welcome the awesome worship team this evening. We are excited. There's going to be lots of joy. I want you to put your dancing shoes on. Get some space. Smile at your neighbor. Testify to them. Relax. This is one of those evenings where you need to be here. Hasn't God been good, you guys? Have you been seeing the stories of transformation? Have you had transformation stories in your location? How about in your cohort? How about in your MC? How about in your location? How about in your cluster? How about in your family? Come on now, make some noise. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Worship team, you are welcome.
Yeah. 1, 2, 3, 4. Hey! 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 Hey!
1, 2, 3, 4.
God is in the building! Hey!
Reaffirmation of sonship.
7, 8.
I now speak in tongues.
9.
I am part of the Baddest Band.
10.
I know the true love of a father.
11.
I was fearful, now I'm bold.
12.
I have led multitudes to salvation.
13.
I am a landlord. Come on.
14.
Alignment to purpose.
15.
I know what it means to be planted in a dope church family.
16.
And the Lord has given us a shepherd that is feeding us with knowledge and understanding. Come on, put your hands up.
the Lord. All the time. And his praise, come on, church, his praise will continually be on my mouth. So are we ready to bless the Lord this evening? I can't hear you.
Are we ready to
bless the Lord?
Let's sing together. We declare, I'll bless the Lord all the time. His praise will ever be in my mouth. I'll bless the Lord all the time. His praise will ever be. Let's sing. Come on.
I'll bless the Lord all the time. His praise will
Receive, receive.
bless the Lord, all my soul, and all that is within me. Bless his holy name. Bless the Lord, oh my soul, and forget not his benefits. He has healed us. He has ransomed us. He has redeemed us. He has kept us safe. He's given us family. He's given us a home. We have a good shepherd. He's given us joy. Give thanks to the Lord. He's worthy. He's worthy. He's worthy. He's worthy. We worship you. We worship you. Hallelujah.
Great things for us.
God of my waiting on you.
God of my waiting for you.
King of Kings, isn't that name wonderful? Now would you make some noise if you know what I'm talking about? Because he is the ruler, he is the king, he is the Lord of lords. He's worthy of all praise, he is worthy of all honor. He's the reason why we are here today as we celebrate 16 years of worship. Others, come on, make some noise, people. Hey,
come on,
he's worthy.
Praise God. We are going to do something together. Are you ready for it?
I am ready.
We are going to make noise for something that God has done for us. Are you ready?
I am ready.
For over 1,200 missional communities.
Yeah.
Woo, woo, woo. For over 20,000 members.
Yeah.
More than 1,500 salvations every week.
Yeah.
Almost 50 locations.
Woo.
Come on, let me hear you make some noise. Turn to your neighbor and just say, I'm excited.
I'm so excited.
God has been good.
God has
Thank
been
you for
good.
Being in the room. Thank you for coming to celebrate what God has done. Let me hear you clap your hands and make some noise. God has been good. God has been wonderful. Come on. Amen.
You are all welcome to this anniversary, this jubilation.
Woo-hoo!
I need you to turn to your neighbor. It is only fair that, you know, you find out who they are and then you take a selfie with them. Psst. What is life if you can't take a selfie with your neighbor?
Let's do that good anniversary selfie. Come on, pull out your phone. Pastor Steve, you guys, this day is not coming back, so you have to maximize. Get your phone right now. If you're online, get your phone right now. Let's do it! Come on! I love it, I love it, I love it!
Don't forget their name. It's
Bambi,
only right
the band. The band never gets a selfie. Oh, let's take a picture with them. Fall in, fall in, fall in, fall in, fall in. Hey! Let's do this, let's do this! I love it. Post the picture. Tell everyone you love to be in the room and to get here.
Yeah.
All right. Ladies and gentlemen.
You can go ahead and take your seat. And if you just took a selfie with someone who is single, why not?
Why not?
Yeah, yeah,
if
yeah,
not,
yeah.
Why not?
Yes, yes, yes.
I love it.
You are all welcome to this anniversary, this celebration. Thank you for coming from far and wide, close and near. Thank you so much for joining us for this celebration this evening. Now, whoever is out there watching us online, if you are not in the room and you are close by, you are the only one. So get in the room right
honestly.
Away.
Yeah.
And before we go any further, I would like for us to really recognize any special group of people. Now, I would like for us to recognize those people who are actually joining us for the very first time. If today is the very first time you're in the room, is there anybody?
If this is your
goodness,
oh yeah, we
have people at the back.
I told you.
Glad to have you join us. And even in a more special way, I would like to recognize all of the pastors, our guest pastors who are joining us today.
Come on, let's stand up and give
Come
them
on,
a warm
them
welcome. Don't stay in your seat.
Pastor
our guest
Alex,
pastors,
Pastor
you are welcome.
Pastor Faith.
We see some of you.
Pastor
Gerald Mewe and his wife are here.
Reverend
Bishop
Gustav.
Danny is in the house. Reverend Gustav is in the house. Pastor James, we see you. Pastor Alex and Pastor Faith. Pastor Asadi, all of you. Thank you, so much for gracing us with your presence this evening.
Oh yeah, so glad to have you. And to all of our location pastors, cluster leaders, we celebrate you and we
Come
honor
on.
You. Thank you for being here and making this happen. Now, you all know that we are celebrating 16 years, but there was a man and woman sent from God without whom we would not be celebrating.
Would
16.
Not be here.
Yes.
That's right, ladies and gentlemen.
I don't know
on
why
your
you're
feet
still...
or on your chairs. I don't know where you want to stand, but this is our moment to give thanks for our shepherd, Apostle Mose, Pastor Ari. If you want to stand on your chair, you can stand on your chair.
For
Let's
some reason, I can't
right
even
now.
Hear you.
Thank
Come on, mess
you,
some
thank
people.
You, thank hey. You. Yay! Thank you for your obedience, Apostle Mose. Thank you for saying yes. Come on now, guys. Make some noise. We have a good shepherd. Amen. Awesome. Please have your seats. Relax. It's going to be an awesome, awesome time. And right now, before we go any further, for our guests, if you'd like to use the bathrooms, they're right on your left. One of us is going to wave right there at the door. If you take just behind that door on your left, there are bathrooms right there. You'll be able to use them. Please feel free, relax. If you need a drink, you'll be served. Feel at home. Awesome. I'm going to invite us right now to turn our eyes to the screen and watch a video together.
Thank you, Father, for your goodness, for your kindness, for your grace. Everything we are is because of you. It's because of you. You saved us. By your grace, you called us. We bless you. May your name be praised always and forever. In Jesus' name, amen. Awesome.
God has been good to us. Today is an emotional and exciting day for me and for you. Our stories have been changed because God thought about this before we were born. And I'd like us to declare together some powerful words that God has given us as a house. In this year, in last year, there are words that God has given us, and they don't are not only for worship harvest, but we declare them on behalf of the Church of Jesus Christ. In our generation, in our nation, we are decreeing and declaring together. So as we put these words up on the, some of you have memorized them, some of you haven't, it's okay. They are written, they are established in heaven. We are going to take on the prophetic. We are going to decree. We are going to declare. We are going to inform heaven and hell, the angelic and the demonic. We are telling them that we are here to take over the time for the Church of Jesus Christ to be established on top of every mountain is now in our lifetime. Do you agree? Are you ready to prophesy? I said, are you ready to prophesy? Let's declare. 1, 2, 3, let's go. Now it shall come to pass in the latter days, that the mountain of the Lord's house shall be established on the top of the mountains and shall be exalted above the hills, and all nations shall flow to it. Many people shall come and say, come and let us go up to the mountain of the Lord, to the house of the God of Jacob. He will teach us his ways, and we shall walk in his paths. For out of Zion shall go forth the law, and the word of the Lord from Jerusalem. And of course, this one. Come on, declare. A little one shall become a thousand, and a small one a strong nation. I, the Lord, will hasten it in its time. Father, we thank you for your word. Your word is true. Your word is power. Your word is established in heaven. Will you go ahead and start to decree? Father, we thank you that the mountain of the Lord's house shall be exalted, that a little one shall become a thousand. We declare, Lord, that today is the beginning of our next season, that we see multiplication, exaltation, promotion is coming for your church, for your children in every sphere of influence. And we shall see it in our generation, in our time. Worship harvest, in Jesus' name.
Glory to God. Is God good at what?
Yeah.
Praise the Lord. Worship harvest. 16 years of multiplication, 16 years of church planting, 16 years of transformed lives. The scripture says, all that men would bless the Lord, would praise the Lord for the wondrous things he's done for the sons of men. Do take your seats in the presence of the Lord. We're going to receive testimonies in this house. Right now, I would like to call up to the stage Pastor Joshua Waiswa from Worship Harvest Masaka, Pastor Blesso from Worship Harvest Makerere, and Pastor Christine Dushabe from Worship Harvest Kabale to bless Jesus. Please, Pastor, testify.
Thank you, Pastor Roxy. My name is Joshua Waiswa. Hello, Worship Harvest. Happy anniversary. Yes, I'm here to testify my journey with Worship Harvest. It is an emotional one, but it's a good one. So, 2010, just after I just graduated, I got a very good job, very good for a fresh graduate. I was earning about $3,000. That's my house, my two houses were paid for. My transport, my driver, everything was paid.
Apologies in advance.
So the only thing I had to do for myself was feed and be happy. That is 2010. I wasn't saving. I wasn't investing. I was just being happy. Be happy. So, fast forward, 2013, I tell my friends that I'm getting married and no one should pay a penny for my wedding because I could afford it. Little did I know that funding was going down. So I announced my wedding, funding goes down, we hit rock bottom. I had to go and bargain with my friends to contribute to my wedding. So quickly, the wedding takes place, my friends contribute, family contributes, the wedding takes place, but we are at rock bottom. When we are married, I remember we hit so rock bottom that we had 2,000 shillings between us and total poverty. Before the 2,000 shillings, we were so broke. The only thing we had for food was our wedding cake. You know the cake you carry? So we had 2,000 shillings and we're really starving. We didn't have money, we didn't have everything. So God is faithful. We're even struggling to get church because we would drive from where we're staying in Seta on one Sunday to Jinja for church and on another Sunday to St. Francis. When we're tired, my wife said, "I'm tired." So she looked for a church and found Worship Harvest.
Come on.
When we joined Worship Harvest, we joined an MC. We grew, we participated in the MC where we became MC leaders. Then we started a mastermind, became cohort leaders. But that wasn't all. When we did a turnaround, after knowing the principles of finances, we started saving, we started looking after our money, and we invested. Quickly, we're able to buy land. We now own over 200 acres of land.
Come on! Hey, you gave! Please say it again for the people at the back.
We own over 200 acres of land. And 170 of those are next to the lake. We own a business, we own a company, a consultancy firm, and of course we are saving. So we have some liquid cash somewhere. That is the story of our financial growth. Now, on the other front, we are becoming cohort leaders. We are growing spiritually, and we planted Worship Harvest Masaka.
Come on!
Wow, wow. Isn't God amazing?
God is amazing.
That is my Worship Harvest story.
Give a shout of praise to the Lord. Spiritual transformation, economic transformation in this house. Welcome, Papa Blesso. PBDB. Hey. We are sorry, not you. Papa.
Praise the Lord! Hey! Man, that was a powerful testimony, Pastor Joshua. Ish! When I grow up. So, about 7 years ago, I was leading a fellowship at university, in Chambogo University. And a friend of mine called Brian Daniels Mwesigwa, insisted that we should invite a certain man of God to come and teach us the word. Now, at that time, I was the one who signed off whoever would come to the fellowship to teach or not to teach. And because he was my very close friend, he still is, I said, okay, I don't know the person you're inviting, but it's Kawa, invite him. And so when he when the person came over, I later got to find out it was Apostle Mose. He came with Pastor Roxy. And I remember God told me at that time that that is going to be your church and that is the person you're going to serve for the rest of your life. So I immediately joined Worship Harvest. By the time I joined, I was a broke young man. I was an insecure young man. I was dating my beautiful wife, Precious Barbara, then. And I was so insecure to the point that I never wanted her to talk to any guy. I deleted every message in her phone from a man. I don't care. Whatever the name is, I'll get the phone, delete all the messages. I feared that some random human is going to take her away from me. Anyway, I had a very low self-worth. I could not stand and speak in public. I kept all my opinions to myself. I was just purposeless. And I joined Worship Harvest over 7 years later. 7 years later, here I am. I am a location pastor of Worship Harvest. Makerere! Woohoo! I'm happily married to the most beautiful babe this side of heaven. I am now teaching other people about dating and marriage and about how to be hooked. I am a preacher of the gospel. I am a church planter. I have released people to plant churches. Pastor Sima, I send you greetings. And many more are coming. I am an author. I am a songwriter. I am a worship leader. Many things that God has done for me, and I'm thankful to God for the obedience of Apostle Mose and Pastor Ari. Because of you, we are living significant lives. Oh, happy 16th Worship Harvest! Come on!
God is good to us. Let's welcome the mega church planter, Pastor Christine Dushabe.
Hi, Worship Harvest. So my name is Christine Dushabe, and I'm from Kabale. So growing up, I grew up from a Christian family. Things were well, but me, I was living a non-Christian life. I ran away with boys from home. I did all sorts of things. Okay. Somehow, because of how I look, I don't know, I was attracted to boys. And the wrong boys. And mostly Muslim boys. So I ended up having a child from a Muslim boy at a young age. Okay, that's how my story was. So my family, my dad, because he was a pastor, he used to pray for me and all my siblings. Okay, what is Christine going to be in life? Her life is, I never used to booze, but I never missed a party. So my dad used to pray for me. My sibling used to pray for me. Some of them are here, the Judiths, the Sanders. They used to pray for me. What is going to become of Christine? So during lockdown, I was minding my own things. I was invited to Worship Harvest by my sister sometime, so I came. So when you come and you're a new person, you write your name and your number. So I had left my number. So during lockdown, someone called me. Hi, Christine. My name is Eva. I'm inviting you for an MC. What is that? I didn't even go the first time she called me. So the second time she called again, Bambi, I went. It was cool. There was a lot of food. Hey! You people, that MC, eh? So I used to go there because there was food. And it was usually on Wednesdays in the evenings. I don't eat. I make sure on Tuesday night, that's when I last eat. The whole day on Wednesday, I don't eat because I know where I'm going in the evening. There is food, and you live and park. We used to park. So I got into an MC. My aim was to come, eat, go. But then they're on my case. They invited me for, It was online. Garage used to be online. I attended. I never liked it. Trust me, I never liked it. MC Live, Pastor B3 used to be with Apostle Moses dancing on stage. I never liked it, so I had my headsets on. Whenever they are dancing, I also have my music. Remember, I was a party person. So it kept on. I kept on going. Somehow, one time I had a profound dream about what I was doing. And when I gave this dream to my MC leader, she told it to Pastor B3, and Pastor B3 told her, that dream means that person has to be planted, and it is serious and it is urgent. What is being planted? So I got scared because it is urgent and it's serious. So Pastor Eva helped me be planted in Worship Harvest. I used to come. We used to go for evangelism. I never went for evangelism. The first time we went for evangelism, I remember we went as a zone. We had 46 salvations and 26 were mine. So, I can bring back people to Christ. But remember, I'm not yet planted very well, so I come and go. But I used to go on evangelism. Somehow people used to open their hearts to me. They come back to Christ when I talk to them. The whole of 2021, I won about 400 souls back to Christ. And 2022, I was called by Pastor B3 to go to Kabale for evangelism. We went with Pastor Jeremy. We traveled throughout Western Uganda, and we had over 200 salvations that weekend when we went. And I didn't have a job then. I was looking for a job. And when Pastor Bisi told me, you will go to Western Uganda, to Kabale, I was like, it's okay. I don't even have a job. I will go. But I had a job in pipeline. So fast forward, I got the job. And then the conversation came back to go to Kabale and plant. I had just gotten this job. It was just 1 month. But I felt convicted to go and plant Worship Harvest Kabale. So I quit my job. I went, planted the church on 13th March. This year, 2022.
This very year.
It is really, really working. So many things are happening in Worship Harvest Kabale. Souls, people are coming back to Christ every single week. Kabale is a place, I don't know, people drink a lot of alcohol. People come to church when they are high. So they slept over, they slept while drunk, or they drank in the morning, but they are high in the morning. But they used to come, they come. But I thank God, I have 3 men who have been drinking. They have stopped because they come to Worship Harvest. I have an MC leader. He was leading an MC, but somehow he stopped. And I asked him, why did you stop leading an MC? I had seen something that he was doing. I never told him, but I went down on my knees and asked God, help this young man leave this thing. Because it is what I was struggling with back then. He was sleeping with a girl. And how do I tell him, stop sleeping with that girl? But I prayed for him. So he came to me and told me, I'm very sorry. I stopped leading this MC because I was feeling convicted. I'm sleeping with a girl and I'm drinking. Though you don't know, but I cannot be telling people to live a Christian life while I'm living the contrary. So I told him, no, you cannot, because we are all struggling with different things. You're going to continue leading that MC and you're going to thrive. So he went back to leading the MC and it is really, really growing. I just want to thank God because it is really working. Indeed, it is working. It has worked for me. It has worked for
Glory
me.
To God. Work.
It has really worked for me. I am changed. Somehow, as if boys don't see me, somehow God has distanced them from me. And I like it. I like it. And When I just joined Worship Harvest, I stopped wearing some clothes. I never used to put on pants because I thought maybe my body is how. But now I put on my clothes very well and I'm very happy and it is really working. Thank you so much. Thank you so much, Pastor B3. You saw in me what I didn't see. Like, God is so good, you people.
God is so good. Isn't he amazing?
Isn't he fantastic? Isn't he supernatural? Give God a shout of praise.
Woo, woo, woo. One more time, just make a shout of praise to the King of Kings. Because we know one thing is for sure, there's nothing too hard for God. Is there anything too hard for God?
No!
I said, is there anything too hard for the King of Kings?
No!
Awesome. Now, I would like us to welcome a special group of people to the stage. Rumor has it all the finest things come from Worship Harvest Nakawa, but I don't know about that. I don't know about that. I see what you're doing. You're not celebrating with me. Okay. Ladies and gentlemen, let us welcome the Worship Harvest Nakawa dance crew. Come on, people. Hey. Yeah.
check, 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 check. Check, check. What up, what up, what up, what up, what up? Worship Harvest, make some noise! My name is Wake, and I am a spoken word artist. And I come from Worship Harvest Makerere. Yeah, so check me out, check me out, check me out. Quick mathematics, I'm the one that is too blessed. It got me thinking Mokisa should be my new name. I used to wake up in the morning to some T-Pain. Until Jehovah came and loosened up my two chains. Check me out, check me out, check me out, check me out, check me out. Now I'm on a roll, now I'm on a roll. I see his favor flow like a waterfall. I know that I'm a child of the Most High on the throne, so when my spirit is running low, I just make a call. Check me out, check me out, check me out, check me out. So, tell the enemy to never mess with me because he'll be dead meat. Amotinyama yambuli. He no longer has a bone that he can pick with me, and he can blame it on the son who came and sorted out the beef. Check me out, check me out, check me out. Christ sorted me out, otimutiere. So things won't be falling apart, chinua chebe. I say Christ sorted me out, otimutiere. So things won't be falling apart, chinua chebe. All things work together for me and I don't pay them. All glory to the Son, alifungulia heaven. Now, are you guys having a good time? If you know the song I am going to perform next, you would be getting up on your feet right about now. You would be getting up on your feet right about now. Now, I want to check which side has the highest energy, all right? Are you ready? Are you ready? Are you ready? This side, let me hear you say, Chamagero, Magero, Magero. One more time, Chamagero, Magero, Magero. Alright, alright, alright. This side, let me hear you say, Chamagero, Magero, Magero. Chamagero, Magero, Magero. Huh, okay, alright. One more time. Let me hear you say, Chamagero, Magero, Magero.
Chamagero, Magero, Magero.
Eh? Hey. But Pastor Angela, you have a microphone. All right, this side. Let me hear you say, Chamagero, Magero, Magero. Huh, it looks like this side is the one. It looks like this side is the one. DJ, let's go. Yeah, 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 yeah. Check me out, Amalina nizo mugoda mwizukulu wa Joyce tulia nabo nikasaiza katontono kati nempo oyo nekube kiko agamale visena mbukufunya bikonde mbula na go amanika ngema tondo kimokiti ngandi mula go. But he rose again, I am supposed to be dead, I am supposed to be dead. He rose again, tikube ya baba tumula ngambu setina kule. He rose again, I was always in the dark with time oh meme tekule. The enemy wanted to come over me but the Lord overcame. Don't get it twisted on me, I'm a miracle. Hey, when I get to drop the lyrical man, I get him, I get him, I get him. Mataki my taki manye. The kama futamo baka chamane. The komu kisa madding into the name. Are you ready? Say what?
I am a miracle.
I am a word.
I am a miracle.
I am a word.
I am a miracle.
I am a word.
Yeah.
My God is what?
My God is visible.
I am a war. Are you ready?
Miracle.
Let's go.
Spiritual
one. Chamagero, magero, magero. Say what?
Chamagero, magero, magero.
This side. Say what?
Chamagero, magero, magero.
This side. Say what?
Chamagero, magero, magero.
This side. Say what?
Chamagero, magero,
listen. Okuzonga ni muto muto stana baida taka kukuba kiko agezere kubuli kimo manaisu ze kali ndikusa na kimo mamu wana kuboti kansa nutuli kusa titwe tagano kimo twafuniro superhero, twafuniro superhero. Man with every disease, the devil was coming at me, but eyali ataka mukumbe ya beya so waku washi pimba zeyali yanku bidawo na kimo ze nikoma mazwi. The enemy wanted to okatonda na kasunya matwi. Don't get it twisted on me, I'm a miracle.
Magero, magero, magero.
Hey, when I get to drop the lyrical man, I get him, I get him, I get him. Taki my taki manye, di kama futa mo baka jamane, di kama kisa. Are you ready? I am a word.
I am a miracle.
I am a word.
I am a miracle.
I am a word.
I am a miracle.
I am a word.
Yeah.
My God is what?
My God is visible.
I am a word.
I am a miracle.
One. Two, say what? This side, say what? This side, say what? This side, say what? This side, say what? Hey, 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 are you ready? Are you ready? For the last time, I want to see which side has the greatest energy. Are you ready? Are you ready? This side. Say, chamagero, magero, magero. Chamagero, magero, magero. Chamagero, magero, magero. Chamagero, magero, magero. Thank you.
Chama, 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 what? Chamagero. Hey. Tell your neighbor we have more testimonies. Oh yeah, we have 16 years of testimonies. At this point in time, it gives me great pleasure to invite to the stage the Mathesons, pastors of Worship Harvest, Wairaka. Come on, show them some love. Pastor Victor Kalemera, Pastor Worship Harvest Chebando, and Pastor Hannah Atai, Pastor Worship Harvest Jogo. They're going to testify of the goodness of God.
Hey, happy anniversary, Worship Harvest! Oh. It's so wonderful to stand in front of you. My name is Hannah Atai, and I'm a location pastor at Worship Harvest Jogo. Yeah. So quickly, my Worship Harvest story. While I was in senior six at Wairaka College in Busoga, Worship Harvest, the music team comes. And when they sang, I made up my mind. I think that was in 2005. Okay, I've told you my age. Yes, I made up my mind that I am not going to apply in any other university because they said that they were in Macquarie and they were with St. Francis. So I was like, I am not going to apply in any other university. I have to go to Macquarie University and I have to look for these people. And so I only applied to Macquarie, and they gave me money to apply to other universities, and I ate that money foolishly. Then afterwards I was like, but what if I don't actually get a place in Macquarie? But anyway, thank God I got a place there. I get there and I look for Worship Harvest, and they had left and started a church. I did not find them until 2008. And then I got a friend of mine, Joy, who told me one Saturday that I'm going for choir practice. I'm like, where? Worship Harvest. I have been looking for these people. I left everything that I was doing and I went for that choir practice. And that is how I joined Worship Harvest. Yeah. And so we are at Katikati, I'm in the music team. They start Worship Harvest Nalia. I come with the people here at Worship Harvest Nalia to start Worship Harvest Nalia. And along the way, Apostle Moses says we are starting Worship Harvest Mukono. And I decide to be part of the team going to plant Worship Harvest Mukono. And it is right there in the planting of Worship Harvest Mukono that I actually found my purpose. Thank you very much, Apostle, for allowing to plant other churches. Because I feel like if I had remained wherever I was, I wouldn't be who I am today. And Pastor Roxy was leading the music team MC. And one day she just gets up and she chases all of us from the music team MC. And she's like, you've now grown. Go and start your own MCs. And she gave us a deadline. Now, where I was staying, all the people around me, you know, already started their missional communities, and I did not have people to start with. And the lady is telling me, you have to start. And you know how with those glasses, she puts them down like this and looks at you, and she's like, what next? So anyway, I went and I started a missional community called Petros Zoe. That is what we called it. And right there, I started with the youth in my community. One of the questions that helped me that time was, what annoys you in your community? So that you can do something about it. She was like, don't think that what annoys you annoys everybody else. And so what annoyed me that time were the youth who are unemployed and the girls who are moving on those advertising cars, dancing almost naked. And that is who we started my missional community with. Guess what? Right now, that missional community that we started in 2017 with my late husband, Martin Tito Mugonyi, who went to be with the Lord, right now, it is a fully fledged organization. Yeah. It's a fully fledged organization. Along the way, I met the mighty, the wonderful, the only Erin Hogan, now Mrs. Magda. Yes. And we started walking that journey with her. We registered the organization here in Uganda. We registered the organization in the US also. And now we are doing a lot of work that is helping to transform the lives of the youth in Uganda. I can tell you that right now, because of starting a missional community, we are employing about 22 people right now. We are running a teenage pregnancy center, which is rescuing girls who have been especially defiled and left by themselves, and they are pregnant. So we give them accommodation, we feed them, we skill them. Those who are still young, 12, 13, we are working, partnering with other organizations who are sending them back to school. Right now, we feed about over 70 people every day at the Teenage Pregnancy Center. In the community, we are reaching out. We are reaching out to over 200 young people every week. At least we feed those people with porridge every week in the communities. I have boys who have They started a charity club, and right now they are working with Mukono Municipality, with the health inspectors. They are given opportunities to go on the floor parliament of Mukono and, you know, be able to present their findings before the councillors, before the leaders of Mukono as a municipality. And when I look at what has become of them, my heart rejoices. There is this particular boy who is now running a business that now he can afford at least tithe of 200,000 shillings a week. Yes. That is the kind of work that we are doing. I'm very, very grateful. I feel so fulfilled. And out of that, we were able to plant Worship Harvest Jogo. And these young boys and young girls are the ones that I am leading with Worship Harvest Jogo. Those ones who were former gangsters, those who were former drunkards, people who had no hope, and now the ones who are the pastors in that community. I thank you, Jesus, for this journey.
Glory to God. Come on. Welcome with me, the pastor of the Double Mega Worship Harvest, Chevando.
Hallelujah. Happy anniversary, Worship Harvest. I bless the Lord so much for such a church. What a church we have. My name is Victor Kalemera. I'm from Worship Harvest Chevando. Together with my lovely wife, Pastor Paul Kalemera, we lead the mega church, Worship Harvest Chevando. I'm here to share our story. It's a family story, it's a couple story, and it has transformed our lives and the lives of many people around us. We joined Worship Harvest downtown in 2019, and our strategy was to settle, to become members just. So we quickly took back seats. Every Sunday, we would sit behind. And we later got to know that Worship Harvest is a movement. It's not a settlement. And somehow we found ourselves in the space of Pastor B3 and Pastor Jeremy. We salute them and we honor them. So on our anniversary, that was the next year, 2020, they gave us a gift. And that gift was to start a missional community. So we started the missional community with 6 people. And of those 6 people, 4 of them were us, our family. And the 2 were from the neighborhood. So we started this missional community somewhere in Kanyanya on Gayaza Road. And quickly, we did not know what we were supposed to do. But my wife is a very good cook. And so we devised a strategy of preparing very nice food for our MC. And somehow, it was a good one. And we didn't want people to eat snacks. We wanted people to eat real food. And they came, and the numbers kept on growing every week. Not because of food. Not because of food. Hallelujah. Food was part of it, but that was God. Hallelujah. It was God. So we grew that missional community by the grace of God to 30 people. And later on, it multiplied. We planted 2 more MCs. From there, we then became zonal pastors, which was a very shocking news to us, but we took it on. Our zone only had 20 people, and we grew that zone by the grace of God to 300 people. And from there, those 300 people, every month we had a minimum of 100 salvations. in the community and the neighboring areas. So 2021 comes, we start worship, we were challenged to start a location. And at first we thought they were joking, because in that lineup we thought we were nowhere. So we started Worship Harvest Chevando and launched with 1,000 people. Hallelujah. We quickly realized that our community has a lot of children and teenagers, and we reached out to them. We started several MCs, and these guys, these teenagers, these children go out to win souls themselves. On one particular day, when we came home in the evening, we found one of the young girls, about 15 years, who is a cohort shepherd now, and she had a list of 100 children and teens that she had won on that day herself. So right now, Worship Harvest Chevando is at 1,800, and we are still growing, and we want to bless the Lord and celebrate Apostle Mose and Pastor Ari, Pastor B3 and Pastor Jeremy, who gave us the opportunity to rise. In a period of 1 year and a half, we moved from being MC leaders to location pastors now, and we bless the Lord for that.
Come on, celebrate the Lord. Hey! And now welcome with me Pastor Ron and Pastor Ann Matheson, all the way from Worship Harvest America.
Good evening, Worship Harvest. Hey, happy anniversary. Yes, my name is Ron Matheson. This is my gorgeous wife, Anne. And we've been here in Uganda for 11 years now. We came initially with an organization that was building a children's home. And when our time there ran out, we decided we were going to build a school. And so we built a school, we built a teacher training college, and we were really busy. And then in 2018, some friends invited us along to Worship Harvest. And we thought, this is great, this, because it really felt like home. And it felt like home because all of the good things that we had experienced in our church at home, and I'm talking about the good things, not all the other stuff, all the good things we experienced there, we were seeing. Yeah, there was church planting, there was great worship, amazing teaching, there was deliberate outreach, and there was the opportunity for everybody to get involved. And that really appealed to us. As I say, they were the good things we used to from home. Now, we joined with no ambitions of leadership at all, and we actually met Pastor Filter and said, we don't want to be in leadership, okay? We've got enough to do. And so that's how we joined Worship Harvest.
However, COVID came, and we all know COVID was different and it made changes in our life. And so we weren't allowed to go to Jinja, so we had to do things in Wairaka. So we started watching on screen, the two of us, added to four when we were allowed, then it went to 12 when that was allowed with the regulations. And then suddenly we were in the new hall that we had built for the Teachers College. Apostle Mose came and visited. Ron jokingly said, welcome to Worship Harvest Wairaka. Apostle Mose said, it's coming soon. Hey. And it did. May 9th last year, 2021, what a shock. Suddenly, we were pastors. Hey. And it's been an incredible journey for us. It has been just amazing. It's an honor. It's an incredible responsibility that we just are overwhelmed by at times and just enjoy so often. But what is so significant is that we're seeing lives changed, and you can give nothing for that. To see people healed, to see people's lives transformed, recognizing that they don't have to be poor anymore. These things just, yeah. So we are just so thankful that we get to be part of it.
So Worship Harvest has really transformed our lives, and despite our advancing years, that can still happen. And we are incredibly grateful for what has happened. And even in Australia, it's having an impact. There are pastors that we know that have been our pastors through the years that are getting to take a fresh look at how church can be because of what they're seeing has happened in our lives. We've seen what God has done. It's incredible. So God is so good. And we definitely thank you, Apostle Mose, Pastor Ari, so much for trusting in us. We thank our cluster leaders and network leaders, Pastor Chris and Pastor Lynette, who guided us into this pastoring business, and now Pastor Emma and Pastor Angela, who kick us around and shape us and all of that. But to all of the other pastors who have been a part of Worship Harvest that have paved the way for us to be able to live this life, we are so thankful. Happy anniversary.
Happy anniversary. Let's get on our feet and give God a shout of praise and thanksgiving. Hallelujah. Amen.
Praise God, Worship Harvest! Hey. Yo, I like the people who are like, ah, we are not sitting down. That's the vibe! Let's take it up. Oh, it's the trousers for Pastor Solomon. Shababa, I need to do up more stroke very well. Let's take it. Ah, guys. Happy birthday, Worship Harvest. I released a song today in collaboration with an amazing team of worshipers called Moyo Throne Room. Right now, I'm going to be joined by the Christ Warriors as we sing it and worship God together for the first time at home. Hey! And the name of the song is God's Abundant Goodness. Somebody make some noise. Yo! Okay, let's worship God together. Amina. Abugalo! Come on! Are we ready to celebrate? Can we make some noise for Jesus? Listen! Forever will exalt you, my God and King. I'll praise your name forever and ever. Great is the Lord and most worthy of praise. Great is the Lord and most worthy of praise. Hey, of your majesty. In praise to the Lord, His dominion endures forever. Come on.
Hey! Worship Harvest! Can you turn to your neighbor and tell them happy anniversary? Look, neighbor, even if you walked in from the neighborhood because you heard noise, nobody knows. Act like an owner. Say happy anniversary. Hey, chintu chafe. 16 years of God's goodness. 16 years of God's blessing. 16 years of transformed lives. Oh my goodness. If you know someone, including yourself, whose life has been changed because of the ministry of Worship Harvest, will you let out some more noise right now? Also, I just like noise making. Noise is so good. I was telling Pastor Ari that I would have been home right now, watching on the phone, shouting all by myself, commenting all by myself, shouting back at people who can't hear me. It's so nice to have people when you can say, eh? It's so nice. Those of you watching online, sorry. Isn't it amazing? Isn't it fantastic? Isn't it supernatural? I like it. You know, every time we gather together, do you imagine the joy of heaven? I think that's why the psalmist says, behold how good and how pleasant it is for brothers to dwell together in unity. But when we come before God on a day like this, we come to give thanks. That's why we have music, dance, celebration, snacks on your pocket. You know, lots of hanging out, joy in the room, testimonies. And I want to read a psalm and show you another way that we celebrate the goodness of God when we gather together. Are you ready? Will you read with me? All right, let's read together. Oh, sing to the Lord a new song. Sing to the Lord all the earth. Have you done that today? Yes, we have. Sing to the Lord, bless his name. Proclaim the good news of his salvation from day to day. Have we proclaimed the good news of his salvation? All right, let's continue. Declare his glory among the nations, his wonders among all peoples. We've done that as well. Why? Together. For the Lord is great and greatly to be praised. He is to be feared above all gods. For all the gods of the peoples are idols, but the Lord, he made the heavens. Honor and majesty are before him. Strength and beauty are in his sanctuary. Give to the Lord, O families of Worship Harvest. Give to the Lord glory and strength. Give to the Lord the glory due his name. How? Bring an offering and come into his courts. We have sung a new song. We have told testimony of the goodness of God. We have shared about his glory. And now we are also going to fulfill this scripture and give the Lord the glory due his name by bringing an offering to the Lord this evening. I want to challenge you today to bring an offering that is worthy of the praise of God. To sow a specific seed between you and God and declare that your life shall have testimony. The way you've had people testify here, where you're like, how is that even possible? I want to tap into that. That when we say God has been good to Worship Harvest is people. It's you and I. So are you ready to worship the Lord with an offering? And give him the glory due his name? Will you do it with joy in your heart and with understanding? And we will give generously. Father, we thank you for an opportunity to worship you with our substance, with our offering, with our thanksgiving offering this evening. We thank you so much, Father, that as we give, we are tapping into something spiritual. It's not about just the substance, but we are giving you the glory due your name. And Father, we receive a reward of what the giver is supposed to receive. In Jesus' name, amen.
One of my testimonies is that you guys one of my testimonies is that I have no fear. One of my testimonies is that I've been in a space that has gotten the things that God has put in my heart, okay, and brought them out. And that's your testimony as well. Yes. You can also give online. Our mobile money numbers, yeah, are 0778-618-418, 0758-618-418. Cool? I'm blessed to have a father who knows me so deep. He loves me from the inside out, and he's made me complete in him. He knows, he sees the image of a king, rejoicing over me in sweetest song. To you, O Lord, I lift my eyes, 'cause I trust you. You are my light, and you made me see I am beautiful, and I will sing, and I will shout it so.
heart that the Lord sang to my heart, but M.O.G. But then all I hear is this jam, cause I am not to be judged by the words of a mouth, but steadfast, so I must confess my inner strength. You're going to turn to your neighbor and say, you're so beautiful. You can say, I can see the God in you, Mazima. Yeah, I can see the say, celebrate your beauty in me. Say, I celebrate your beauty in me. Say, I celebrate your beauty. I celebrate your beauty in me. So celebrate your beauty. Oh, celebrate your beauty. Oh, so celebrate your beauty.
To first take your seats for a moment. Are you having a good time? Are you glad you came? Once again, we'd like to welcome in a special way the pastors from other churches that are joining us today. Seeing you is a fulfillment of a dream of our apostle, to have brethren, leaders of churches together in unity. Now, as we gave, I noticed that some of you didn't get an opportunity. You were ready with your offering, but the bag never got to you. So we'd like to give you that opportunity right now, excitedly, to run and just put your offering in these baskets so that you don't miss your opportunity. If you're one of those, just run from even upstairs. There are baskets up where you are, so you can put right there, put your offering there. The numbers are going to be on the screen again. Some of you said that the numbers went off too fast, and so we're giving you the opportunity to give right now. Go ahead right now. Just run to the front, do your thing, give to Jesus. Wherever you are, there are baskets. So, I want to tell you something. Can I tell you something? I've also been a bit deprived of conversation with adults, so I'm looking for it. I'm maximizing. Pastor Ari is laughing at me. I've been going to groups and causing chaos. But today I want to tell you a story. Many years ago, I was really young. I'm those kids who went to university early because of being so clever. So when, don't hate the player, hate the game. So anyway, I was those kids who went to university. I skipped so many classes. So I went to, this is not the point, but I just wanted to put it out there. So, I'm not trying to brag or anything. I'm just stating facts. My stories are true. So I joined the university in 2004 at like 12. I was like 12 years old. So I joined the university. Towakana. You guys, we have guests, eh? So let's behave. So I joined the university at 12.
that's not the point. And then I walked into chapel that evening in August, and I found this worship team singing Psalm 91. They were singing scripture, they were singing angelic singing. I was like, I have to join these people. So they told us that we'd meet on Tuesday. I went to the meeting on Tuesday and found this fun group of people who were also serious. People came late 5 minutes late, they were paying money. You pay money for coming 5 minutes late in Uganda. I was like, who are these people and where are they from? Thankfully, I was a university student with quite some time, so I had been in the chapel waiting for a while, so I didn't pay. Introduced myself, started hanging around. What I remember quickly about joining Worship Harvest is that I couldn't tell who the leader was, first of all, because these people are all strong. But then you quickly started to see the person who people were listening to, who was giving direction, and it was Apostle Mose. Young man, young, fresh young man. Still fresh and young, as you know. No, we don't grow old, please. So Apostle Mose, they were preparing for a live fest, which was this big annual concert. We should do it again, like outdoor. We do it. We had Moses Mukisa and friends. If you missed, it was a taste of a live fest. So a live fest would come together, all these people from different churches who are in Worship Harvest. It was just a singing group, and would go and minister. And when I came in, I had been in secondary school, and where I came from, we didn't use microphones. So you would stand here in front of like what, 700 or 800 girls. I can't sample you without a microphone, and they could hear you at the back. Do you understand? We also didn't have instruments, music instruments, apart from drums. But when I said drums, don't think about this drum set, please, I beg. No, no, no. Those ones. So I came into this worship team. These people are so organized. And me, when they gave me a microphone, they would try to reduce the volume all the time. And I was wondering what the problem is, because I know how to project my voice. But the other problem was, I was always off key. And I didn't know, because guys, suddenly, no, Salome is not my daughter. That's not why she shouts. I met her like that. So, guys, listen. I would start singing and I would see people's expressions changing. Now, Apostle Mose, quickly, when you came in, he was as welcoming as he is. You know, he's always telling you how you're so amazing. He found out I could play some things on the keys, tried to help me test and see what I can play. He got so excited. He said, put her on the soprano mic. In like 2 weeks, I had a microphone. I'd never seen such promotion. Yeah, so I'm singing and people are annoyed. I'm sort of like, guys, like, deal with yourselves. Me, I'm good. My problem was, there would be a bass note, a note on the piano, and a note on the guitar, and there would be like 3 keys in my head. I would just pick what I want and I go with it. And Apostle Moses saw the anointing on my life. Hey! And he started to give me opportunity. I get to a point where the only way to help the music team, when they would say, B3 today, you are not off key. They didn't know that I would be miming. I learned that the way to stop people from complaining, I would be on the soprano mic and be like, they'd be like, today, B3, you are on key. Now, here is the thing. If you know Apostle Mose, you know that one of the things that he loves is music, and one of his DNAs is excellence. The man is excellent. The man is excellent. But the strangest thing about Apostle Mose that even some of us who are leading with him have an issue with is he can take interest in a person who you're all like, why? You're excellent. Why are you giving that person an opportunity? That was me. I was off key. I remember he made me lead a song called At Your Throne. I started singing and the instrument stopped playing. I wondered, what's their problem? I must be that good. Then they started again. I want you to know that not once did Apostle Mose ever come to me and say, Pastor Jeremy, what's the problem? Not once did Apostle Mose come to me and say, you're off key. You need to work on your voice. He would keep telling me, you have something. You have something. You have it. So while all of them complained, I was like, you see the man, the leader of the team, the excellent one,
He tells me I have something. All of you just don't get it. Eventually, I started singing on key. By the time we launched the church, I was the key worship leader. I got to a place where Apostle Mose, from that point on, he gave me opportunity to preach. People told him, that girl, she tells too many stories. He allowed me to preach. He allowed me to grow. I've become everything I am in the ministry. It's because Apostle Mose, Mr. Excellence, took a chance on someone. And it's not just me, Apostle. There are so many people that he has taken a chance on. Today we are here because this man of God said yes. And because he's an opportunity giver. Help me get up on your feet and welcome the hero maker, our Apostle, the man of God, our shepherd, Apostle Mose, and his beautiful wife, Pastor Ari.
Wow. What a shock. Welcome. Happy 16th anniversary. Can you help me? Psalm 47 says, oh, clap your hands unto God, all you people, and shout unto God with a voice of triumph. Make some noise and let's celebrate Jesus, the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords. Thank you, Jesus. Yeah. Please have your seats. I just thought, no, this is the incredible, gorgeous, lovely, anointed Pastor Ari. And I thought she should say hi to all of us.
Happy birthday, Worship Harvest! Hasn't God been good? Just stand up and clap your hands again. Shout with joy. Lift your hands and bless God because He's been good. Woo! Please have your seat. That's my greeting. That's my greeting.
She's so beautiful, she doesn't have to say anything. All right. Today is Friday, did you know? So kids are not going to school in the morning, did you know? So those of you who are pretending to be busy already, when we've just begun, Pastor Izo, I can see you. No. All right, we'll make it. Thank you for joining us today. There are those who are joining us online, and there are other people who are joining us in other places. And we are very honored to have a lot of lovely, wonderful pastors from other churches who are joining us. Thank you so much for being here. It's a great honor. All over this whole section are serious mega multiple church pastors and bishops, and this side as well. Thank you so much for being here. Now, I'm going to try and see how to not get into trouble. And this is how I'll do it. Long before we started interacting with a lot of churches, one of the people who looked for me and we became like brothers in the gospel is Pastor Alex Mutagubia, who is here. Amen. So I am going to invite him to bring a greeting on behalf of the pastors. Is that okay? Now, you first wait here. So he came with his lovely wife, Faith, and without Faith, it is impossible to please God. Now, the other person, I'm going to invite three people to bring a greeting on behalf of. Is that okay? Because all these pastors, if we say so and so preach, we will not stop. But the other person, and this one is, he loves us so deeply, and also he is our senior in the gospel. Before we were, he was. So help me welcome Bishop Gerard Mwebe, who will also bring us a greeting. They have all copied, they have all learned this thing of coming with their wives and pastor. Now, that will be another greeting, all right? Pastor Diana is an accomplished evangelist. She lives to win souls. Oh my God. Now, then you all know that at this church, we love, and honor a man of God, Bishop Doug Heward Mills. All right? And we have a serious contingent from Lighthouse UD, United Denominations, and First Love Church. Now, we have here Bishop Danny. He committed one crime. He did come with his wife. But he will come and bring greetings to us again on behalf of that family. So, let me start with Pastor Alex, since he's representing Wetwaziruwana. Please have your seats.
Praise the name of Jesus. Wow, isn't this beautiful? Isn't it wonderful? Isn't it incredible? Isn't it fantastic? Ah, look what the Lord has done. If you are not clapping, I even wonder. Woo! I'm just so grateful to God when I watch what God is doing in Worship Harvest. I know we have hope. And Apostle Moses, thank you so much for hearing God, for obeying God, for believing God, and for staying the course. Yes. And for the team that serves with Apostle, you are an incredible team. We are very motivated by just watching how you serve together, how you love one another, how you support one another, how you have stood with one another, and how you have believed in the anointing on the man of God of this house. It gives hope to the church in Uganda. So we want to say the reason all of us pastors are here is we see Worship Harvest. You have become a great example of what it looks like to follow Jesus Christ and to believe in a generation of men and women that have been called by God. Apostle Moses, you continue to inspire us. Thank you very much.
Yeah. Hey! Please, we are people of a few words. Yeah. Apostle, Mama Ari, the pastors, Worship Harvest, and all the men and the women of God that are here, we love Apostle Mose, we love this church because they love Jesus. Yes. It's a great honor to serve the Lord. And celebration of 16 years, but I believe we ain't seen anything yet. Oh, yes. Yeah. Just love Jesus, serve him, wait and see. Bless you.
appreciate Bishop Gerard.
Wow.
Let's welcome Bishop Dani.
Hallelujah. I can't hear your amen. Worship Harvest. Hallelujah. Happy anniversary. Wow. It's a blessing to be here. I love this church so much. And I love Apostle Moses so much. On behalf of my pastors here, I have Reverend Gustav with me and his lovely wife. I committed a crime, but he didn't. But we want to say we really appreciate this beautiful church and Apostle Moses. I was in Ghana a month ago and for a meeting, and I was with the prophets, you know, and I had a one-on-one meeting with the prophet, and all that I was telling him about was Apostle Moses. I was just telling him about the wonderful things that Apostle Moses is doing in Uganda. Yes, this is your John Wesley. This is your William Booth. Oh, I'm surprised you guys are not clapping. I didn't hear when I said it. You have an anointed man of God, and I want us to stand by him. I want us to support him. I want us to love him more and more. Philippians 1:6 says that, being confident of this very thing, that he who began a good work, I said he who began a good work, is faithful to complete it. If this is 16 years, get ready for 20 years. Get ready for 30 years. Get ready for 50 years. In the name of Jesus. Worship Harvest, we love you. Thank you so much. God bless you, Apostle Moses Mukiza.
Wow, can we appreciate this great men of and women of God? Thank you so much for loving us. Wow, we couldn't have everyone bring a greeting, but they're all here. Bishop Gerard and Diana Mwebe, Bishop Dani, Reverend Paul and his wife, Dr. Alex. I like to always pull out the doctor on important events. Apostle Moses Kalanzi, I think I saw Chirabo around. Pastor, the Macharias. Pastor James Kato is in the house. Hey! This is serious. Pastor Kennedy Kiri, I saw him around with Pastor Lillian. Thank you for coming. Pastor Patrick and Doreen Mohereza of the Vive Church International. I saw Pastor Apollo from Christworth Church. Pastor Brand Sempeba came with his lovely wife. Glad to see you. Pastor Roy Casos, is Pastor Roy around? All the way from, what's that place called? Busika. Or is it Matuga? One of the two. Pastor David Waswa is always with us. I don't know if he's around today. So glad to have you. Pastor Obed Akampira, thank you for coming. Pastor Jackson Lulika, I saw him even earlier. He came, thank you. Pastor James Luwaga, of course, from Jinja. Pastor James Magumba, Pastor Magzi. Oh, yeah, welcome. And the Onens here, Pastor Mike and the Sai. Yay, Mavuno! By the way, Mavuno is Harvest in Swahili, so in case we are just the same church, we're just operating in different spaces. Pastor Asad Diba, thank you so much for coming. Now, have I missed out some of our lovely guest pastors? Am I getting myself into trouble? Pastor Arthur Otim, thank you. Nomuchala, Doctor, thank you for coming. Of course, the Egesas, my neighbors, Christ Prosperity Ministries, and they're also my neighbors in Chitukutwe. Thank you so much for coming. I'm trying to be careful not to get into trouble by missing out some of the anointings in the house. But all pastors, please, you're very welcome. Thank you for joining us. for this important day. Amen. Is Pastor Henry Musana here? Yeah, I was going to come to Nyandama and riot. Yes! Like, what about? Now, at some point I'm going to say something. Don't worry. But do you remember Pastor B3's story of how she walked into chapel when she was only 12? At campus. Now, in math, there are bases. There's base 10, base 8, you know. So she just has not revealed the base she's using. Wait a minute. Is Reverend Moses Isabi here? Oh, wait. Oh, you're very welcome, Sevo. Reverend Moses and his wife have loved us. Loved. His wife is called Auntie Sarah, so you can tell. Moses and Sarah. Moses and Sarah. So I don't know what you people are doing. Reverend Moses Isavie, when he was the vicar at St. Andrew's, is now serving at St. Stephen's Chisugu. He took us in. When we didn't have a building, when we did a, that's where we had our weddings, funerals, everything. I didn't know he was around. Can I inconvenience you, Sebo, to come and greet us? I will not. These people have loved us so much. I was still telling you, he did our funerals, he did our weddings, and do you remember? You all know Mike Breen. If you're in worship obviously, and you don't know Mike Breen, you're in the wrong church. But you know that we were introduced to Mike Breen by Tim and Rebecca Lindsay. Remember that? Now it is Reverend Moses who introduced us to Tim and Rebecca Lindsay.
Wow. It is a delight for my wife and I to be part of this celebration of Worship Harvest, 16 years of ministry of multiplication. The Word of God says, never despise humble beginning. And this was a humble beginning. We are amazed at what God has done and what God is going to do. May the good Lord bless you.
Thank you. Wow, can you hear me give an appropriate appreciation? Wow. And Reverend Moses, one of his children, Pastor Joshua Mwesigwa, is planting Worship Harvest in Achifuma. I don't know whether I'm breaking the news to the family, but the ministry has continued. Amen. Now, I was still telling you that Pastor B3 moment of walking into chapel and then finding us and then me and us walking together, I too had my walking into chapel moment that turned my life around, and nothing that you see here would be possible or would be there if that moment hadn't happened. And I've told you so many times about the man who took me on when I was a student at campus and discipled me and taught me a lot and was even my best man. Ladies and gentlemen, Patty is here. Patty, come and say hi to these people. I didn't prepare him, so he's Just greet. Just these people love you already, so it doesn't matter what you do. So this man discipled me at campus and after campus until I got married, until I left St. Francis to start the church. Up to today, he's still doing the job. He hasn't quit yet. So help me welcome Patrick Minda.
Praise the Lord.
You can have your seats. Lord.
I would like to read a scripture. This scripture is taken from the book of 1 Samuel 23, from verse 26 to verse 28. And it reads as follows. And before I read this, Mose, and your family, Auntie Sarah and Auntie... Oh, is it in order for me to refer to him as Mose? No, over here it is wrong. I am very sorry.
You and me, that's totally in order.
Congratulations. And Worship Harvest family, congratulations so much on attaining this milestone of 16 years. Congratulations so much. I would like to share just one word, 1 second, for one person who may be here, who may need to listen to this. Saul was going along one side of the mountain, and David and his men were on the other side, hurrying to get away from Saul. And Saul and his forces were closing in on David. And his men to capture them. A messenger came to Saul saying, "Come quickly, the Philistines are raiding the land." Then Saul broke off his pursuit of David and went to meet the Philistines. For that one person here, there are some of us who are having circumstances that are just engulfing us and draining us and drowning us. But I just want to encourage you today as we celebrate that God is on your case. He is interested in you to detail you won't even believe. Mose, I just want to thank you so much for the work you're doing here. May God bless you. I remember 16 point something years ago, he came to my home one evening, and we started just having a chat about what God had put on his heart. So I said, that's a very big dream. Let's pray about it and believe God for it. And we began to talk about his dream. He talked about starting a church. It looked so huge and almost impossible. But here we are. God is amazing. May God bless you. I know this is just the beginning.
Amen.
I know you're going much, much higher. Worship Harvest is going places. People are going to be blessed. People are going to be taken to places they've never known they could ever get to, because of the ministry going on in this place. God bless you so much.
Thank you. Can you appreciate Mr. Patrick Minda? Wow. Amen. Well, at some point, preachers gotta preach. All right, here are some fun facts about Worship Harvest. Those who are joining us online, welcome. We haven't forgotten you. Don't add salt in that soup. Fun facts about Worship Harvest. I got this from Pastor Sam Kisa of Worship Harvest Entebbe, who is also our architect. Number of members, Worship Harvest members, 29,347. Wow. Of those members, number of teenagers, 4,764. What a shock. I know some of you are wondering whether you are in the number. Just don't worry. Number of children, 13,875. So if you did math, it means that there are more children than adults. Well, number of members in missional communities, because there are those, there are the members who think that church is just a building you go to, and then there are those who understand that church is a family and you need to be discipled. So there is about, so those are 22,975. So there are about 7,000 people in repentance. Number of missional communities, 1,286. Wow! Number of cohorts, these are the, so there's missional communities and there's a cohort to which the missional community leaders belong. 336 cohorts. Number of locations, 49. Number of hosting centers, those are not yet locations, but they are running services, 61. Number of chaplaincies, this is where people were running services in schools, 84. Number of pastors, 81. Number of ordained pastors, those who threw away the key to their lives. Jesus. 12. Number of couples on the eldership, 42 couples. Number of plots of land. You want to know? Okay, I will not tell you that one. 40. Number of auditoriums, church buildings where people can meet and the rain doesn't hit them and they pray. 10. I even got this one. Number of chairs which we own. You know, a lot of people hire chairs, but they are the chairs which are ours. 2,883. What a wow! Thank you, Jesus! Wow, God is amazing. Please have your seats. I may need to preach something. It's so good. I was working it out that with 49 locations, it means that the average number of people at a worship harvest location is about 600. 600 people. And I really thank God for that. Amen. So location pastors, cluster leaders, network leaders. Thank you so much. Zonal pastors, cohort shepherds. Tomorrow is the Meet the Shepherd gathering. I hope. Cohort shepherds, are you ready? You're teaching from the book, The Principle and Practice of Honor, chapters 1, 2, 3, 4. So don't start at 3 o'clock, because how will you teach 4 chapters? You'll just be pulling on commando instead of what? So you start by 10, tomorrow 10. Then Sunday we have garage. Still, this anniversary celebration is going on until Sunday. And then at 4 p.m. on Sunday, we are going to have a special anniversary edition of Movers and Shakers. Hey, do you want to know the special artists, the guest artists? Do you want to know? Moses Mkisa and Friends is one of them. Hey! Mufubu Kasoma. Sit down. What care we? Malice. Akameza. 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 Uh-huh. Akachi. Sit down. So don't miss Movers and Shakers. It's going to be burning hot right here 4 p.m. all the way to 7 p.m. We're going to dance. We're going to shake. We're going to move. We're going to do it. Hey! Life is good when you're in Jesus. When you're not in Christ, life is bad. It's terrible. It is sad. You don't have anyone to lift you up with those challenges. Today I want us to have a conversation about the prophetic destiny of the church. And I would like to tell you that the prophetic destiny of the church is great. Greatness is the future of the church. Of all the things that exist in the world today, whether that's universities, schools, hospitals, name it, all the wonderful governments. People used to think that national boundaries are now fixed. No one will ever move them. We now know it's not true. Yeah. People are now fighting to keep boundaries and they are moving. A time will come and some countries will not exist. Yeah. Yeah, there was a country called Yugoslavia. Do you still hear about it? No. Countries will go. I mean, I'm talking about countries where there is no president left. That is serious. Some of you, the school you went to. Is it too early? Is it too early to start? The school you went to no longer exists. Yeah, some of you, your schools were shifted from town to the village. Yeah. Yeah. Life is in session and change is a constant. Oh, yes. Yeah. Bishop Doug said something profound. He said, every 50 years, there are new occupants on planet Earth. Every 50 years. Every 50 years. There's a completely different group, having their own styles, having their own dances, having their own music, having their own every... And it's like the previous people didn't exist. And while those people are occupying, they think... you know, every generation of preachers, including Paul, said Jesus would come when they are alive. Yeah, Jesus said... Paul, the dead in Christ will rise first. And then we who remain will be what? Caught up. That's what you saw your preaching. We are in the we who remain. We have this idea that we are... Wow. So things are changing. But I can guarantee you, there is one thing that when you study history, study sociology, study anthropology, study theology, and all the ologies, you'll find out that this one has a bright future. And that is the church of Jesus Christ. Yeah. The church of Jesus Christ has a bright future. Like Andrew Mack says, the future is bright. You have to squint to look at it. Oh, yeah. I'm telling you, right now you may not be feeling bright yourself. Maybe before you came, you may have quarreled with your spouse. Yeah, some people still do that. Or, you refuse to give the border guy all the money he asked for. You had an opinion as to how much he should be paid. He had an opinion as to how much he should be paid. And by the time you walked in, you were not feeling entirely spiritual. Am I talking? Or when the offering bag came around, you checked with your wallet and it spoke to you. And it said two words, no thanks. Now, So it's possible to be on a Friday night and you are not exactly feeling like the future is bright. But the thing I've learned in life, when your stuff is not working, you attach yourself to the thing that is what? That is working. And before you know it, you are winning. Hey, yeah. That's why we drive cars. Do you know why we drive cars? We can't move as fast as them. So you just sit and be like, I'll be there in 5 minutes. You're seated. It's about being in the right environment. Am I making sense? So the church, if you want to win at life, if you want to win at life, get into the church, serve in the church, and if God ever gives you an opportunity in this lifetime while you can still breathe, plant a church. There is no greater honor than serving God in the church. Am I making sense? Oh, wow. I have my notes, but I don't know what's happening to them. Because other things are popping up. Give me a very interesting scripture in, of all books, Leviticus. Leviticus 21, from the beginning. I'll show you something. Then I'll come to my notes. Leviticus 21. You think you can read? It happens to be in English. I could use some water. And the Lord said to Moses, speak to the priests, the sons of Aaron, and say to them, none shall defile himself for the dead among his people. Next verse. Except for his relatives who are nearest to him. His mother, his father, his son, his daughter, and his brother. Next, also his virgin sister, who has had no husband. For her, he may defile himself. Thank you. Thank God it's water. Otherwise, he shall not defile himself. What's the next words? Being a chief man among his people to profane himself. The point I'm making is not about who should handle dead bodies and who shouldn't. It is the idea that in God's mind, among the tribes of Israel, the 13 of them, because there used to be 12, then some guy called Jacob, oh Israel, came and told Joseph, your sons are mine. You know some people have that much power, eh? When they tell you your sons are mine, that's it. They are his. And so they were 13. So God had a problem. Because in his arrangement, they are supposed to be 12. There are people who... This is a celebration, I should know. Yeah. There are people who disturb, who can disturb the thoughts of God. Yeah. When the sons of Korah were disturbing Moses, he told God, do not accept their offering. Yeah, and God said, okay, now, move away from them because something is about to happen. Moses, he got angry, he told God, do not accept their offering. There are people who can tell God things and he listens. So Jacob, he's like, these ones are mine. And God, I think God's like, oh no. In Revelation, they're supposed to be 12. Now they are 13. What do I do? You know, God had new Revelation, the book of Revelation, before Jacob came around, making certain pronouncements. So God decided, okay, let's bring them in. I'll take out one. He took out the Levites and said he would be their inheritance. Now, these ones who served in the house, he said, he talks of them and says, see, being a chief man among his people. Oh, yeah. When you serve the Lord, you, in your family, in the country, in everywhere, you God starts to elevate you. Yeah. Yeah. But Pastor James was supposed to be a food and something, food science and technologist. Can you imagine food science for a man who doesn't eat? Should have been so wrong. What a shock. Being a chief man. Guys, worship harvest. Do not go to your grave. I want you to suspend death right now until you have served the Lord to the degree that you feel like, okay, I can now go. Yeah, I'm not saying quit your job. All of us, we have served while doing other jobs first. Yeah, if you quit your job, you'll go hungry. Don't come to saying, nah, I'm here to serve the Lord. Where is my Toyota? No, please. There is no Toyota for you. But let's get into it. Start that missional community. Grow it. Start a cohort. Become a zonal pastor. Launch a location. Start a hosting center. It is the best thing you will ever do with your life. And this one, I'm telling you from experience. I have had the opportunity of not being a pastor and of being a pastor. Some of you, you have had only one, not being. So you don't have authority on this issue. Yeah. 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 You only know one side of your life and somehow you think it works. No, it does not. You haven't tried. Because Jesus opened the door for us and expanded the thing beyond the Levites. Bible says he has made us kings and priests in the kingdom of our Father. In other words, Jesus opened the door for all believers to become chief men. Am I making sense? But people are still tolerating around. They are not taking the opportunity. It's like, how can you be invited to this kind of promotion and you refuse? You're like, me, I only want to be an architect. No, be an architect and plant a church. Dr. Joshua Iswa here was testifying. He's a vet doctor. He planted a church. Pastor Fiona is a professor. She's a pastor of the church. Pastor Paul. That whole bench has a lot of doctors and not these ones from Pemba. Plants! Oh, yes. You must plant a church. That's what we do in this worship harvest. We plant life-giving, disciple-making, community-renewing churches. That's what we do. So if you're here and you are not planning on planting a church, I don't know what you're planning on doing. Are you with me? It's like you go to Barclays, or is it Absa, and you want to sell potatoes. No! They lend money. That's what they do there. Here we plant churches. Hey! Being the chief man. And you know what? The way it works, there are about, if I'm generous, about only 1 billion real believers in Jesus. The real ones who at least feel sad when they sin. Yeah, who at least feel some sense of remorse when they've done something wrong. Those should not be more than 1 billion, right? But we are 7.7 billion now on the planet. It means every seven people, there is a priest for every seven people on the planet who is refusing the priesthood right now. The way it is, the reason there are few Christians is we have refused the priesthood. But the numbers are there. 7.7, if you round off, that's about 8 billion people. And 1 billion who are already in Christ. That means just 1 for 7. 1 for 7. 1 for 7. And we would get the job done in a year. In a year, we can get the job done, Bishop Danny. If people take on the priesthood, if people decide I will be the chief man among my people. Are you with me?
Yeah.
Yeah. That's why we are trying to plant churches. We've planted now 49. Next Sunday, Pastor Kathy is planting in Nakauka. Who else is planting? Hey, Natifuma Banange. Natifuma is planting is Joshua wants to go around. And Joshua and hey, and Carol. Yeah, dad is here. Now you can't tell him otherwise. He's planting next Sunday. Daddy and mommy are here. They've had Reverend Moses and Auntie Sarah, your prayers have been answered. One of your children has entered the ministry of pastoring. The pastor said, "Kabira, good to see you." So the reverse key and wrong about. So one for we have been trying, but you know, 50 churches are so few. In fact, God just gave us a new vision to plant 3,000 churches by 2042. Yeah. So in the next 20 years, you'll be seeing a worship harvest everywhere. Yeah. Everywhere. Yeah. That's the idea. And we used to be scared about these things and talking about them. But look, the rapists, the thieves, they are not scared. Yeah, can you imagine the budget they came up for Lanyard's burial? Ria, just, you're thinking, are we burying a man or what? People are just, they have, someone decides on this one's burial is when I'm going to buy a plot. Yeah. I'm going to start a business with this one's burial. They have inserted things. And they are not ashamed, but we are here being ashamed of the gospel and planting churches. No, 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 no. Hey. So, pastors, for us, we are going for 3K. I don't know about you guys. 3K. Yeah. And we figured out how it is going to get done. Every church plants one every 3 years. That's all. If every church plants one every 3 years, our strategy started in 2018, with 12 churches, we should have had 36 by 2021. 2021 ended, we ended with 40. So we were ahead by 4. So, yeah. We have Romans 1:5. Let's get into the text. Together through him, we have received grace and apostleship for obedience to the faith among all nations for his name. Through who? Through Christ. Those who are in worship harvest, you are familiar with the up, in, out triangle. Up from Luke 6, yeah? Jesus went, spent time with God the whole night, and then he called his disciples to himself in, and then the out. They went out and ministered to the crowds. I saw it in here. Through him, him is up. We have received grace in the invitation to love and faith. And apostleship out for obedience to the faith among all nations for his name. Apostleship. The Luganda version of apostles makes it very obvious. Omutume. the sent one. When your mother said, Asadi, Wanji mama, genda kukaduka, ondetele sabuni, no munyo, no abuto, you were an apostle. Yeah. You were what? Sent. Agenda biimba le mebiera vira. Sabuni, umunyo, no abuto. Sabuni. Got some apostles here. Instead, they came back with Big G, Sweet Peps, and what? Big Mom, Safi, yes, Safi. What? Yeah, that's how some apostles are behaving, even toward the Lord. They've sent them to plant churches. Huh? We've apostleship. Now, that word, there is a Latin version of it. Is it Latin? You know, Dr. Alex is here, so I can't mix up things. I think the Latin version is missio. Apostleship, missio. Out of which we get the word mission. Mission. Out of that same word, we get the word missile. When you think about a missile, what do you think? High speed, focus. What is going to happen at the end of it? Impact. Impact. When you hear incoming, you duck. Everyone is diving for the ditch. That thing is coming. That's you. That's you. Yeah. When they hear incoming or whatever, Natifuma incoming, all the demons are like, Tufu day. And you know, they can't die. They can only go to hell. But am I making sense? Am I describing your life or the life you are yet to start living? Bishop Danny here is a missile. All the way from Ghana. Landed in Uganda. Started a church from scratch. Yeah. He's learning Luganda. You speak as if you are about to steal. But nothing. What's going on? Yeah. Pastor Alex. Missiles. Me, when I look here, you think you have come to church. I'm just saying, you're going to plant a church. Yeah. We know. And by the way, if you don't like to leave Uganda, you like your matoke, chikomando, chapati, chili sauce, chips, Nyamachoma, chips, chapsis. Your best bet is to plant a quick alley while there are still places. Yeah. We will not be squeezing two churches on the same street. Once we finish nearby, we'll be like, Togo. Mali. Congo. So, ebintu bye yune kwata katinga wachaliochi, etifo. Yeah, take Kampala before we send you to Karamoja. Yeah, because even Karamoja, people must go. So, you see the people who started early, like Pastor Angela, they're enjoying life here, singing. Wow. Late starters, we have to go further. That's how it works. Hey. Apostleship. For what purpose? Obedience to the faith among all nations. Without exception. all nations. Look, this is the prophetic destiny of the church. So, either you and I participate and see it, or God will raise other people. Oh, yeah. Did you know that David wasn't God's first choice? Yeah, God's first choice was Saul. Oh, yeah. But he was too important for the job. So he says he got this one who was following sheep. Ewes, he calls them ewes. Yeah. Ewes, for those who are struggling with God. It's a tribe. The important people, Saul was done, was tall, the right height, the right stature. He was designed to fight those Goliaths. Too important for the job. Because let me get this small boy. You know what? I believe I was never God's first choice for this church. I was just a small boy that he picked somewhere and said, let me try this one. And even now, I'm very careful. Yeah, you can't start saying, because now they call you apostle, you start getting a big head, you can't go through that door. God can just say, and you're gone. Yeah. He doesn't need to even use too much breath. You know, God can blow you with the air from his nostrils, not his mouth. Have you ever tried blowing as an insect using your air from the nose instead of the mouth? Instead of, you go. That's how God can displace you. Look, we are all here on the mercy of God. You have one life. Make it count. Make it count. Make it count. Yeah. You'll be shocked when you get to heaven. A lot of the things that you have spent, whatever, they will not be there. It will only be the people who you reached for Christ. They will be there welcoming you if they get there before you. Yeah. All this, whatever, career, this, promotion. That, let's chase the career and promotion while serving God. What's the purpose? I'm not going to compromise my message even if you keep quiet and look at me like that. I'm not going to massage your disobedience. That's not my job in this church. God has called us to plant churches. We will plant churches. And for those of you who are too important, too rich, too educated, too whatever, just relax. They are coming. They are coming. They pray like graders. They fast like there is no tomorrow. They don't have your qualifications. They don't have your pedigree. They don't have your life experience. But their heart after God, they are coming. You're going to see them. You are going to see them. They'll be healing the sick, raising the dead, leading thousands to Christ. And you'll still be there disturbing with your opinions. You'd be like, these are young boys. We taught them in Sunday school. And then what did you do after? Yeah. 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 They'll be sitting at the front. You'd be like, but these are our children. Yes. The anointing doesn't know age. Yeah. Isaiah 2:2. Isaiah 2:2. Now, when it shall come to pass in the latter, look, every day you live is the latter day. Do you think there are other latter days beyond today? No. Today is the last day of history. Today is the last day of history. You can't be writing 2025 history. No, it's not there. Those are assumptions. Jesus can come anytime. Or even if he delays you, you can go anytime to find him. So these are the latter days. Today is the last day of history. Are you following? Well, today I come to preach. People are like, maybe what? It shall come to pass in the latter days, which are these ones, that the mountain of the Lord's house shall be established where? On the top of the mountains. Don't think Kilimanjaro, Everest, what? That's not what they're talking about. They're talking about the institutions of the world. And shall be exalted above the hills. And all nations shall flow to it. The church is the greatest institution on earth. All nations, look at us here. From different backgrounds, we are all worshiping Jesus. There are people speaking all kinds of languages right now all over the world, worshiping Jesus. All nations. And it says, next verse, many people, this is the prophetic destiny of the church. Many people, pastors, many people are coming. They shall come and say, come, let us go up to the mountain of the Lord, to the house of the God of Jacob. He will teach us his ways and we shall walk in his paths. For out of Zion shall go forth the law and the word of the Lord from Jerusalem. Many people, all nations. This is the prophetic day. We are not losers. We are not here making noise, consoling ourselves of, okay, life has done, but okay, at least we are going to heaven. No! We are the greatest force in the universe right now. The Church of Jesus Christ. In all its shades and colors. That's why at this church, we don't abuse any church. Those who agree with us, those who don't agree with us, those who abuse us, those who think we're a cult, everyone, we just bless. We even contribute financially. We bless because we know we need them. That church that they hate your guts, you need them. Yeah, if it fails, you'll have to fight your demons and their demons. Oh, yeah. There are people they are reaching that you can't reach. Yeah. All churches are necessary for the gospel. All nations shall flow to it. Think about it. He says, the mountain of the Lord's house shall be established. Where? On top. The worst demotion you can ever face is quit pastoring and go do something else. That's serious. Because you've left the thing that is on top, you have gone to something else. Do you get what I'm saying? Yeah. It says, on top of the mountains. They are not equal. Church and government are not equal at all. At all. Yeah. Church and cultural institutions, Simanyi, what, I'll not name them. They are not equal. How many governments do you know which have been around for 2,000 years? They are not equal. Ish. Prophetic destiny of the church is great. Great. Amen. It's like a case of, you know, like when we are young, the first time you go to town, they tell you, you bathe three times. You what? You're going to town, you go with your mother to the bus station. You get into those old buses. They move so slowly, but when you are moving in it for the first time, it moves, it is so fast. And then you're seeing the telephone poles moving behind, running fast. That's like the church. You come with all your burdens, weaknesses, sins, and problems, and you join. And you just see the telephone poles moving behind like this. Some of you don't know about telephone poles. That's the church. That's the church. Amen. Friends, this is the thing. All nations shall flow to it, shall be exalted. Wow. Can I show you something? Isaiah 60:22. You know this one. Ruth is about to start showing me my time. A little one shall become a thousand. A small one, a strong nation, not a weak one. I, the Lord, will hasten it. You, one like this, having made that decision tonight, you can become 1,000. And you can become a strong nation. Yeah, that's what Jesus does in our lives. Where else will you ever find that opportunity? Look at your workplace. Your boss is trying to make sure you don't go up. Yeah, here we are trying to make sure you go up. Like, where else do you find such an opportunity? Can you imagine? Jesus is so secure. He said that we will do greater things than him. Yeah. How often does your boss tell you that you're going to do greater things than him? Yeah. Jesus said, these ones, You know what? My conviction is that the most amazing, efficient churches have not even been planted yet. We have seen nothing yet. You wait. Yeah. We marvel at these Nigerian churches that have 500,000 members. What? You wait. You're going to see churches with millions. Yeah. They are coming. The prophetic destiny of the church is great. As I start to conclude, Daniel chapter 2, verse 34 to 35. The story is that Nebuchadnezzar had a dream? Yeah. And he was a complicated man. He decided, you tell me both that dream and the interpretation. Otherwise, say your last prayers. So people were saying their last prayers until Daniel came and said, no. I can tell him both the dream and the prayer. So he told him the dream. You were sleeping, you had this dream, there was a statue, gold, silver, bronze, iron, and then iron and clay. And then he gave him the interpretation that there would be different kingdoms that would come. And when you read Daniel, you find out that the kingdoms were, actually he told him that the statue of gold would be his kingdom, which is the Babylonian Empire. Afterwards would come silver, which was the Persian and Median Empire. Cyrus and who? Darius. Remember those guys? Afterwards would be bronze, the Greek Empire. If you read later, they were like a leopard in the imagery. Very fast, Alexander the Great. And then afterwards will come the empire of iron and clay. Iron and clay. Roman Empire started as a republic and then broke up into those enclaves. And he says, in the days of these kings, the God of heaven will establish. We will get there. But that's what, in the days of these kings, which ones? The Roman kings. The God of heaven. That's how Jesus came in that time, during the Roman Empire. But he's still telling him the dream, and he says, you watched while a stone was carved out without hands, which struck the image on its feet of iron and clay and broke them in pieces. Next verse. Then the iron, the clay, the bronze, the silver, the gold were crushed together and became like chaff from the summer threshing floors. The wind carried them away so that no trace of them was found. And the stone, the stone that struck the image became a great mountain and filled the whole earth. Wow. 120 people in the upper room have become 2 billion now. Oh yeah. That's called growth if you don't count calculate between 120 and 2 billion. Because some people's idea is the devil is going to beat us until we are in a corner and then we'll be suddenly rescued. No. You're not reading the right Bible, my friend. If the people in the upper room read it like that, they would have stayed there and cowered. Maybe they read it like that, that's why they cowered until the persecution came and they had to go. We will not wait for persecution. We are going to go. Amen. Daniel 2:44. I told you I'm finishing. And in the days of these kings, are you reading? The God of heaven will set up a kingdom which shall never be destroyed. And the kingdom shall not be left to other people. It shall break in pieces and consume all these kingdoms, and it shall stand forever. Where is the Babylonian Empire today? Where is the Greek Empire today? Where is the Roman Empire today? Where is the Medo-Persian Empire today? Where is the British Empire today? Oh, yeah. Bible, they used to say that the sun doesn't set on the British Empire. They've been now squeezed back to one island. The church keeps going. I pity those who fight the church. Daniel 7:13 to 14. I'm finishing. I was watching in the night visions, and behold, one like the Son of Man. Are you reading? Some stuff you have to read it for yourself to believe it. Coming with the clouds of heaven, he came to the Ancient of Days, and they brought him near before him. Then to him was given dominion and glory and a kingdom that all peoples, nations, and languages should serve him. His dominion is an everlasting dominion which shall not pass away, and this kingdom the one which shall not be destroyed. Hallelujah. Daniel 7:27. Then the kingdom and dominion, further down the same text, then the kingdom and dominion, what does it say? And the greatness of the kingdoms under the whole heaven shall be given to the people, the saints. The kingdom shall be given to who? The saints of the Most. Are there any saints here? Paul writes and says to the saints at Corinth, the saints were at Lucida. Hey, the saints at Impiji. The saints at Kabalagala, the saints at Nakawa, the saints at Najera, the saints. Hey! Yeah. What have they received? You see, the problem is people have postponed this thing. They think it is for later. Don't think it's for later. Yeah, it's for now. It's for now. It's for now. Now. It's for now. Look what he says in Daniel 7:18 as we close. But the saints of the Most High shall receive the kingdom and possess the kingdom forever, even forever and ever. What is the one word that featured in Jesus' sermons more than any other word? Kingdom. The kingdom of God is like this. The kingdom of God is like this. The kingdom of God. You think he was telling us about the future? No, he was telling us about the present in which he lived, because he brought the kingdom. The King of Kings came. My friends, don't throw away your valuable life pursuing other things. Do not look. You think it's church is for just sufferers? No, we are not suffering. Look, even people who don't plant churches suffer. Yeah, I think they suffer more because they are suffering for perishable things. For us, when we suffer for an imperishable crown. Hallelujah. Do not throw away your one opportunity. Do not throw away your one opportunity. Let's stand and pray. Just stand and pray in the spirit. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. We are closing. Let's stand and pray in the spirit. We bless you, Jesus. We honor you. Thank you for the opportunity to serve you, the opportunity to love you, the opportunity to lead others to you, to disciple others for you, to point them towards you, to give them an opportunity to know you. We bless you, Jesus. We bless you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Come on, come on, let's pray. Spend some little time praying. We are closing. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, yeah, because come on, pray. Give thanks to God, the giver of life, the giver of grace, the giver of opportunity, the King of kings, the Lord of lords, the Lord of glory. Yeah, we thank you, we thank you, we thank you. Thank you, Father, for this opportunity. Thank you for 16 years of worship hours. People trying to fulfill. Thank you that you have loved us and called us to yourself. And that you call us to go to others, others, others. Those who are perishing without knowing you. Those who are struggling without friends. Those who are lonely. Those who are in pain. Those who have received medical reports that have no solution apart from you, you're calling us, you're sending us, you're compelling us to go to them. So even as we celebrate, even as we give thanks, we open our hearts to you. We say, Lord, we will go. We will go. Amen. Amen.
Amen.
I know this is a great celebration of great, wonderful Christian people. But if you are here tonight and you've never given your life to Jesus, that's the first step. How can you serve a person that you don't know? So we want to give you the opportunity. Most people here have made that decision already. If you're there, and I know you're watching me online, many of you, I just want you to put your hand up and say, I want to get saved. I want to get born again. I want to walk with Jesus. If you're there, you're there. And you're there. I need to see your hand. You put it up straight. Everyone is praying, so they are minding their business. You can mind yours. Where's that hand? Oh, did I miss it? All right, thank you. I see that hand. Someone else? Someone else? You're like, Tonight. Look, God wants to make your life great. God told Abraham, I will make your name great. I think God wants to make people's names great here. And you don't have to do it yourself. He will do it himself. Thank you. Thank you. I see that hand. Someone else? Anyone else? You're like, tonight, I'm going to follow Jesus. Is there a hand somewhere else? Why don't we do this as we close? Can I have those people who are putting their hands up? Come to the front. You're giving your life to Jesus. Yeah. There are more people. I give myself away. Yeah. I give myself away so you can use me. More people. I give my Check with your neighbor in case they want you to escort them. Just check with them. I give myself away. It'd be like it was at the anniversary of Worship Harvest that I gave my life to Jesus. Oh, I give myself away. Anybody else? Anybody else? So you can use me. My sister, we welcome. Thank you, thank you, thank you. These are the boldest people in this room tonight. I need more bold people. I need people who say, I'm not ashamed of Jesus. More bold people, more bold people. Just come, I'm waiting for you. Check with your neighbor, please. Don't make assumptions. We are closing. Check with your neighbor. I gave myself away. Amen. My brothers and sisters, this is Pastor Jeremy right here. He's going to go with you over there. He'll lead you in a prayer of faith. And tonight, we believe that you have received Christ. Hey, that's when I'm about to end. Some more people are coming. Bold people are coming. Come on now. Can we celebrate these bold people? Come on. Welcome, welcome, welcome. Thank you for giving your life to Jesus. Welcome, welcome. I gave myself away. Welcome, welcome. Best decision of your life. Quite a number will pray. Can we pray together, including those online? Pray after me, yeah? Say, Lord Jesus, tonight I give my life to you. Take my life and do something significant with it. Do something great with it. Forgive me my sins. Fill me with your Holy Spirit. And enable me to walk this new life with you. Amen. Okay. Thank you, Jesus. Now, I want you to go with Pastor Steve. Pastor Steve. Awesome. Wow. Wow. Now, I've been telling you we are finishing. We are still finishing. What was the message? The prophetic destiny of the church is great. There are people here, you've made up your mind tonight that you are going to plant a church. Okay? Come, come now, come. I want my church planters to come. Yeah, there are those who already decided, you're even on a certain WhatsApp group. I'm not talking about you. I'm talking about new decisions. It has occurred to you that this is the best thing you can do with your life, to plant a church. Come on now. Thank you, my sister. Come now. Come quickly. Yeah. We are going to plant churches. Thousands of churches. Thousands of churches. Thousands of churches requires thousands of church planters. Welcome, my brother. Hey, this is serious. Come on, people are coming. People are coming. Hey, people are coming. Planters. Welcome to my world. World full of fun, adventure, courage, faith, territory taking, myself away. Hey. Welcome, church planters. We're gonna change the world together. We're gonna change the world. We are going to change the world together. Hallelujah. So you, I give myself away. Hallelujah. we celebrate these bold church planters? You shall plant churches.
Yes.
They shall be big.
Yes.
They shall take territory.
Oh, yes.
You shall be men and women of renown.
Yes, Lord.
Thank you, Father, for your children as they step forth in faith. Anoint them mightily. Give them wisdom, extraordinary wisdom. Your word says that through wisdom a house is built. That they will build the house of God by wisdom. Wherever they go, to whichever country, to whichever district, to whichever city, we give them cities now, 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 now.
Yes.
Let them step in cities, and may cities, principalities and powers bow down to the authority now that they carry in the name of Jesus. We bless them. The same way you blessed Isaac, blessed Jacob and said, may God bless you. May he make you a great assembly of peoples. We bless them. We bless them. The same way Rebecca was blessed and said, may you become a mother of tens of thousands. May that be their destiny, that out of their obedience, there will be thousands, and out of those thousands, there will be other thousands and other thousands. For the earth shall be filled with the glory of God as the waters cover the sea. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. Now, friends, I want you to go over here to Pastor Chris and Pastor Paul. They are going to take your numbers. We are going to start a journey. And before you know it, you'll be planting a double, mega, multiple church. Can we? Hey! Let's celebrate. All right. We are ready to close. I think we have had a good time, haven't we? Ah! Has it not been a wonderful time in the Lord? You wait. You're going to see churches. Eh? Now, please bring the cake. Don't sit. Please, just exercise a little bit. Bring the cake. Hey. Oba, we are going to cut it from there. They are not hearing me. Bring thou the cake. Amen. Now, as they bring the cake, I'm going to invite my very special friend, Apostle Grace Ubega, to come here and greet us at least. He had a conference. But Erai, I don't know how he escaped that conference and managed to come. Eesh. Praise God. Today we had something called Catch the Fire in Chambogo.
Yes.
But then he had invited me, so I kept saying, God, I pray that someone extends. I pray it extends. And it extended. For me. Because, man of God, we just want to say we are celebrating you.
Amen.
I didn't want to miss this, and I've not missed it. I just thought he was not going to see me because I didn't want the cameras to see me. My wife is also here. Let me also put her in the spotlight. We love you.
Thank you.
And your wife and the men and women of God who are here today to celebrate this wonderful gift. We are forever grateful to God for the gift of Worship Harvest to the world, not Uganda.
Amen. We receive it. Pastor Gerard, Bishop Danny, Pastor Alex, all the people were who said something. Of course, Pastor Ari, network leaders, please come. Pati, of course. Pati doesn't have a title. I need to come up with one. Awesome. Where are the network leaders? Are you a movement or a settlement? Okay, can we come forward? I think the pictures look better when we are near the cake. Who is the MC? I'm the one, eh?
Hey! So we are going to count from, we'll do 16, then 20, right? How about we do 100
to 3,000. Yeah, let's go.
In multiples of 100. Ready? 100, 200, 300, 400, 500, 600, 700, 800, 900, 1,000, 2,000, 2,000, 3,000.
Wow. Amen. Happy 16th anniversary, Worship Hours. Here is to 3,000 churches by 2042. Because we are all going to plant, right? Why don't we close this service? Thank you, Father, for your kindness and your grace. You have made us glad. We pray for any among us who may be going through difficulties, that you will walk with them. We speak to that situation. We command it to be subdued under the word of God. And may there be glory on the other side of it. We bless you. We thank you. In Jesus' name, amen. And may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us soon and forever. Our guest pastors, I'm going to ask these network leaders to lead you out quickly as we...